Because of his cerebral palsy, Christopher has to rely on this expensive, clunky, environmental control device if he wants to be more independent. For him, an iPad was a dream. Thanks to the Tekla Shield and a voiceover hack, Christopher can now access iOS 6. Except for gestures, which are a big part of iOS. Apple adds switch control to iOS 7. And Mac.
So, today I'm going to let Alex tell you about how you subscribe to Skin Ball and iOS 7. So, how old are you? I love this.
Yes, okay. I'm not going to spend too much time showing you how to set up switch control and what all the settings do. There are great videos out there, like this one from Luis Perez, that explain this in great detail. The link is in the description below. I want to talk about how I use switch control to do almost any gesture you can imagine, without actually doing it. You can use more than one switch, however, I find that it is simpler to just use one. Providing that the setting is turned on, you can double tap with the switch to bring up a menu. This is what makes the switch control feature so great. From here, you can access the home button, the gestures menu, the device menu, where you can access things like multitasking, notification center, control center, etc. You can also get to the settings menu, which allows the switch user to customize settings. The settings menu also has a button for turning on point mode. Point mode is a very handy feature. It allows the switch user to access apps that are not set up for voiceover. Switch control is built on the voiceover platform, which is how it knows how to scan buttons. So if an app is not configured for voiceover, point mode makes it accessible. Switch control is very clever. It knows when you open an app with no buttons it can recognize, to automatically switch to point mode. Here you can see me playing The Room, a game that would have been impossible for me to access on iOS 6 because it has no buttons to scan. Point mode makes this possible. The Room also takes advantage of all the cool gestures that Switch Control comes with. First, there are basic pans to move around the scenes. Then there are double taps for focusing on an object. Then there are hold and drags to drag an object, such as a key. Finally, there is an awesome gesture that allows me to turn that key. When the camera app opens, point mode is not automatically switched on because there are buttons that Switch Control recognizes. So, this is when the user has to engage point mode manually. Point mode is useful in the camera app for focusing on an object. This is a personal preference, but I also like to use point mode in Safari. I find that, when Switch Control is trying to scan a web page, it is a bit confusing to know what it is going to scan next because there are so many buttons on a web page. Point mode makes it quicker for me. Switch Control can support many different Bluetooth switches, including the Apple Wireless Keyboard. I use Tekla Shield DOS set to white mode. One thing to note about using this is that the Tecla Shield OS sends a signal to iOS when the Switch user releases the Switch. This took me a while to get used to because all other Switch hardware, including the first generation Tecla Shield, sends a signal as soon as the Switch is pressed.
I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. Also, sing this song. This is Christopher and I. Home down in the...